folks. I'll do a quick video on this, so it ain't going to be real quick, but there's a lot to cover here. This is the Sony streaming player that's similar to the Roku 2 and the Apple TV. This is the SMP-N200 Sony streaming player. One reason I selected this, I went up to get a Roku 2 box, and I decided to get this because it had more stations that I want. I basically wanted, Netflix and YouTube. Roku currently does not have YouTube. This has Vudu. It has Slacker, which I wanted. I wanted to get 5.1 quality sound for my Bose sound system. So it's got Netflix and YouTube and Slacker and Crackle, which is also free movies. I also wanted that. But it's also got Pandora, Hulu Plus. It's got pretty good selection of stuff here. But anyway, that's the main ones I'm going to use. You can hook up with Wi-Fi on this unit or with a hardwired 10BASE-T connection. You can do regular TV. You can also use the component video cables or HDMI cables, depending on what quality you want. That right there, I don't know if you can see them, is the connectors on the back of the unit. That yellow one on the far left is power. And then you've got your video and audio connectors. Then you got an HDMI connector. Then on the far right side is your... it actually has an optical audio connection if you want to use that. Okay, so it's got pretty good content selection. Pretty happy with it once I got it set up. I got to tell you, these are not easy to get set up. I'm pretty electronically minded, and I did have some problems with my wireless. I finally got my wireless connected and everything, but for some reason it was dumping out on me. It would play sometimes and not others. The guy at Sony said I could put a static IP in, and that would probably solve my problem. But what I did is I just hooked up a wired connection real quick to get it working, and I really am happy with it, so I'm glad it worked. But I'm sure I was able to get a hold of Sony tech support, so sure, it does look like there's enough options out there in the settings that you can pretty much hook this thing up to any kind of wireless. I have a pretty tough setup to hook up to on my wireless. The encryption I'm using and everything is... my son has trouble hooking up a lot of times, but anyway, I was able to hook up, but I was having some issues. I think I could have worked out, but I just, like I say, it was right next to my switch, so I just ran a wired cable. I'm sure, though, with Sony support, if you need them, you'll be able to work out your issues. But anyway, here's I'm going to show you the YouTube experience first. This is hooked up to my YouTube account. Of course, you have to go out and register this box with Sony's site. That's one of the things you got to do to get it working, and then you got to go in and activate the box on Netflix and all that. So that's the toughest part of this, is getting it registered and getting all your different channels. Really, Netflix is the only one. The paid services are the toughest ones. I'll just play a minute of my little EDC video on YouTube here. This is one reason I went with this. It starts it in that little thumbnail. Just hit enter and it goes full screen.
It's going to be a very quick little video. Less than 5 minutes, maybe even less.
The Roku did not have YouTube.
This is my everyday carry.
So this is the reason I bought this box.
Tried it. This is what I carry for a knife. And it's a pretty good all-around use blade. It's got assisted open and all that.
Okay, so
it's light. It's got a pretty intimidating presence to it.
That,
in case I need it,
is the YouTube. Now I'll show you Netflix. I'm going to show you, I already started watching Apocalypto. I'm going to go out and restart Apocalypto for you to give you an idea what the HD looks like. Of course, it's only going to be so-so through this cell phone camera, but it's pretty dang good. I'm pretty impressed with the quality. I really am. I like it quite a bit. That's why I'm glad I was able to get it working. Sony did seem pretty helpful, so I highly recommend this box, other than the fact that you better plan on a day or so getting it working between getting all your registration set up and working out any kinks you might have. There's Apocalypto. Okay, I don't want to play too much of that, or I'll be getting in trouble with Sony or YouTube or Netflix or somebody because of licensing. So that gives you an idea of what Netflix looks like. Now you see the thumbnails work on that. Now Crackle works pretty good on here too. It's free. But for some reason the thumbnails don't work on it. They've got a bug in it. Sony said the engineers are fixing it right now. So it should be. See, the thumbnails don't display, but it does read down at the bottom. Down there, it tells you what it is. So, like if I want to... Oh, shoot. I went to the wrong deal here. Crackle. Go back to Crackle. Okay, so it says Crackle Originals, Crackle Minisodes, Crackle Television, which is what I want. Go to that, and then down here it says Three Stooges. Select that. And then it shows all the episodes. Like I say, you can read down at the bottom here what the episode is. You just don't see a thumbnail. Which, they're fixing that, and I don't think it'll take them very long. This is a pretty current product with Sony. They have the opportunity to sell quite a few of these if they get it together. I'm pretty happy with the quality I'm getting.
Introducing Minute Maid Pure Squeeze. It tastes just like a...
Going to get a commercial first on Crackle. Crackle runs on by commercials.
Want to play that game?
But that'll give you the quality. That's HD, that commercial.
All day long, you win. Oh, it's a dumb game.
Turn the volume down just a little.
100% pure squeeze, never from concentrate. Put good in, get good out.
Yeah, you got commercials on Crackle. But that, like I say, that was in HD. Now this is Three Stooges. Okay. So there's Crackle. Crackle works good. Now I'm going to go out and show you. I'm going to fire Slacker up. Play just a minute of Slacker through my Bose speakers. Let me see here, the little music thing at the top here, and then we'll go down to... Oops, I did something wrong. I hit the home button, which I find myself doing quite a bit on this thing. The home button is right by the main button. Slacker. Let me turn my speakers on. It looks like they are on. Okay, and I'm going to go down. I happen to like dance music, so... let's see. Top stations... And then down here is dance. Okay, just do a minute of this and then we'll cut out of here. Thank you. there you go. That's about all I'm going to show you. I don't want this video to be forever, but pretty nice little unit. I like it a lot. I think it's worth your time and effort. I think all these boxes are kind of a hassle to get set up. But like I said, I think everything is doable. It's easier to do it in the daytime, though. If you do it in the middle of the night, you're not going to be able to get a hold of support. So I did mine. I tried to do mine at 2 o'clock in the morning, which probably wasn't helpful. But like I say, all in all, it wasn't too bad. But you better plan on spending the day, the afternoon, getting all the kinks worked out and getting all your registrations put in. And once you get her running, it's pretty sweet. Very happy with the, it's basically HD quality video and 5.1 audio, so pretty awesome. I probably would pick this over the Roku because of the channel selections. I'm pretty happy with it, and I think it's only going to get better because I got the idea Sony was really working on it. It only took me about 5 minutes to snake my way through Sony's touch tone selections. Basically, you end up doing all other products a couple times, and that's where you end up getting to the right place. And they can give you a direct number to the streaming player support, which I'm not going to give out here, but they do have one once you get through there. Like I say, first thing you got to do is go on Sony and register once you get the box, and then you got to go back out into the unit, and the unit will give you a code that you go back onto Sony and put that code in. And then you have to go to Netflix and activate your box on Netflix, if you have Netflix. The other stuff, the free stuff, you don't have to do that. But like I say, pretty cool. Just make sure you have somebody that's pretty good with electronics, and don't get discouraged. You know, once you get it hooked up, it's pretty cool. I think I'd recommend this product. It's got excellent quality video and audio. So, and the selections of content are, at least it had everything I wanted on it. I mainly wanted Netflix, YouTube, Crackle, and Slacker. So it filled all the needs that I had. So anyway, that's the Sony streaming media player. I would recommend it. It's a pretty good little unit. Thanks for watching.